smo da je Voker majstor za mizansen, da to radi, da pravi kako njemu odgovara. Ali smo se plašili da se zaista nešto nije desilo sa tim poginulim ljudima, da nije bilo nekih dejstava i van borbe, da nije bilo eventualno nekih unakažavanja leševa. Mada su svi tvrdili da to bila čista borba i čista pogibija u ratnom sukobu. Ja sam i tako sa tom dozom straha ušao u Račak i kada sam ušao u džamiju, mnogo sam se uplašio da ne nađemo nešto, uplašio, nego sam zabrinuo da ne nađemo nešto što bi moglo zaista da odjekne u javnosti veoma ružno.
Ima želji deca? Nema. To pominjali.
Lična karta ima. Nema ženi deca. Nema masakrirani kao što su predstavljali.
Pronađeno je 40 leševa.
We have found 45 corpses.
Svi ovi leševi će biti prebačeni u Prištini na Institutu za sudsku medicinu.
All of these corpses are going to be taken to Priština to the Institute for pathology.
Mi nastavljamo uviđaj na terenu dalje.
And we are going to continue with the standard procedure in the field.
Idemo na teren.
Gde
god idemo, mi da ošemo uviđaj, možete da dođete.
And wherever we go, you can come.
Thank you.
Spremni smo da sarađujemo.
We are willing to cooperate. They have changed the scene.
Right.
But the investigative judges here.
Hajde da vidimo šta ima ovde.
Je, automatska puška. Tamo je kundak gdje pokušao da pravi. Ovde je ranac sa bombama.
I ovde isto kineska.
To su kao 1, 2, 3, 4, 4...
Puta 10, 40.
Okvira.
Okvira, e. Čekaj da vidimo koliko su okviri. Jesu ove kineske proizvodnje?
Da.
Ne diraj to.
Pretpostavlja se da je ovde bio smešten štab.
We assume that the Ovaka. Headquarters had been located in
s obzirom na mašinu za kucanje, izdavanje naredbe od strane komandanta,
considering raspored machine for typing.
Evo vidite, ovo je uniforma.
106 kandidata.
E, neka dođe da vide.
Čaure, koje milimetre su? Rekao ste 12?
12,7.
7?
Ovo moj čel.
Kako se zove ovo gnezdo?
Mitraljesko gnezdo.
Rafal.
On ide u uniforme i prsuk, jel da? Ovi robovi skroz do dole izvode tamo na put.
Da spravi drugi bunker. Građe za drugi.
Došli smo ceo rov, silazili smo dole prema selu i kad smo došli do prvih kuća ponovo, ponovo je počela pucnjava u gornjem delu gde su bili rovovi i prema nama i prema policajcima koji su obezbeđivali lice mesta. Naravno, više je bilo besmisleno da se sedi tu, posebno što se čula artiljerijska paljba prema kamionu u kojoj su leševi već bili natovareni. preko radio stanice smo doznali da pucaju minobacačima na kamion. Vozač je seo i brzo je napustio to mesto. Iako su za njim pucali, on je uspešno odveo leševe na Institut za sudsku medicinu.
Prvog dana ranje je jedan policajac, znači 15. 17. i 18. i 19. dva policajca i jedan pripadnik policije stradao. Onaj koji je rukovodio operativno potrebnom grupom 15. ujutru, pokojni Miro Mekić je 19. januara stradao na samom vrhu Kršina. Da bi smo savladali taj vrh, odnosno da bi smo imali pod kontrolom komunikaciju koju su oni koristili za vezu sa, prema izraelskim planima, za vezu sa štabom njihovim u Paštriku.
So maybe the Serb forces didn't abide by the rules, you know, the laws of the war, but they didn't, it was not just simply a civilian village being slaughtered, and it was a village where you had trenches. I was really puzzled, and I said, but you know, I owe to the truth to tell what I saw. So I wrote a small piece the following day, based on this fact, just saying that maybe Walker was a little bit hasty or too fast in giving his conclusion. It was a big scoop. It was very powerful because it was published by the Figaro in the morning and by Le Monde in the afternoon. Then this article made a big fuss. I mean, Walker said it was terrible, that he would not accept to see me. And my American friend told me, you bastard, you kill the story. Because what they like, I mean, in what I would call the Hollywoodization of media, is like you like to show like, you know, bad people killing good people and the West watching doing nothing. Tuesday night, after I published this famous piece, I had a dinner with my friend Christophe from Le Monde and some American team that was on the spot on that Friday. And his name was Captain Scott. We had dinner together. And we told him, what happened? Why you didn't... tell Christophe on Friday what was happening and why you know, you had to wait on Saturday that Ucheka comes and said to the world, oh, there is a slaughter, what happened? And he said to us, it's very difficult. I mean, what we know, because nobody was on the ditch on that day, on Friday, but he told us that you know, he... On Saturday and Sunday and Monday, he had gone through the villages, and then people had told them that, you know, sometimes you have to make sacrifice when you have a great cause, sometimes you have to make sacrifice.
Finska se ekipa su uključila za rad 22. januara, znači 3 dana po našem početku. Početku našeg rada. Veoma kasno, da smo čekali do 22. mi bismo izgubili dragoceno vreme. I promene bi bile takve da bi imali mnogo teškoće u utvrđivanju uzroka smrti i drugih eventualnih povreda koji bi našli na Lešinu. Mi smo do njihovog dolaska obdukovali 16 tela. Ostatak tela je obdukovan u mešovitim timovima sudsko-medicinskim. Finska ekipa, lekari iz Finske i lekari sa instituta koji su došli da budu članovi sudsko-medicinskog ekspertnog tima. A onda smo se vratili na prvi 16 leševa koje smo mi obdukovali,